Hey guys, it's Rachel from the Little Ring Lamb, and today I have a book review on The Truth About the Harry Kubert Affair by Joel Dicker. This will be a no-spoilers review, and also if you're new to my book reviews or just a refresher, I write my books in 5 different categories. Plot, characters, cover, suspense, and overall in terms of reading very soon, 5 out of 5, not so soon, 1 out of 5. So basically, this book is phenomenal. I'm so happy I picked it up. It was actually, if you watch my most recent book haul, it was a bargain book I just found on a whim, never heard about it before. But I was instantly intrigued and really wanted to read it, and I picked up right away. It's a pretty hefty book, and I finished it pretty much in 3 days, and it's 643 pages. So it had me reading late. Like, I don't really read late. Like, usually I'll cut off time around 12 because I don't really like staying up too late, because then I have to sleep in longer to compensate it, and I like to go to bed at 12 or 12:30 and sleep until 8 or 8:30 during my summer at least. So I was staying up late reading this. Like, it was so good. And if you watch my end of the year things, like my top 10 of, like, they'll be my top 10 of 2016, this book is definitely right where it's placed now. I haven't read, obviously I can't tell the future, but right now, this is definitely in the top 3 books I've read this year. And it was so good. I just can't get over it. I absolutely love it. One of my new favorites. So if you like mystery and suspense novels that aren't super scary, if you read Gillian Flynn, and you were fine, not as scary as that. I would say it's really less scary than that. And those books I don't find scary, and I'm a big scaredy cat. It's definitely has some of the more, like, scarier moments, but it's not like a horror novel. It's more thriller, suspense than that. And it takes place of a book inside a book, and it's a very interesting concept, and there's lots of layers to this book. But I think I'm just gonna read the inside flap, which I usually don't do. I like to summarize myself, but it intrigued me so much, I need to read it to you guys. So August 30th, 1975. The day 15-year-old Nola Kellergan is glimpsed fleeing through the woods, never to be heard from again. The day Somerset, New Hampshire lost its innocence. 33 years later, Marcus Goldman, a successful young novelist, visits Somerset to see his mentor, Harry Kubert. I hope I'm pronouncing his last name right, too. One of the country's most respected writers, and to find a cure for his writer's block as his publisher's deadline looms. But Marcus's plans are violently upended when Harry is suddenly and sensationally implicated in the cold case murder of Nola Kellergan, whom he admits he had an affair with. As the national media convicts Harry, Marcus launches his own investigation following a trail of clues through his mentor's books. The backwoods and isolated beaches in New Hampshire and the hidden history of Somerset citizens and the man they hold most dear. To save Harry, his own writing career, and eventually even himself, Marcus must answer 3 questions, all of which are mysteriously connected to who killed Nola Kellergan. What happened one misty morning in Somerset in the summer of 1975, and how do you write a book to save someone's life? A chart-topping worldwide phenomenon with sales approaching 1 million copies in France alone and rights sold in more than 30 countries, The Truth About the Harry Kubert Affair is a fast-paced, tightly plotted cinematic literary thriller and an ingenious book within a book by a dazzling young writer. And this is a translate copy, and it was translated by Sam Taylor, and because obviously I didn't get it in French, which it was originally written in, and loved this book. So plot, I give a 5 out of 5. I thought this plot moved really fast. Throughout the chapters, like when you start a new chapter, you see a little bit of advice from Harry. So he is obviously Marcus's mentor. So basically it'll be like, just scrolling through. So it'll be like chapter 31, which is like the first one. And it'll be like, the first chapter Marcus is essential. If the readers don't like it, they won't read the rest of your book. How do you plan to begin yours? Like, he gives them little advice. And then it starts a chapter, and I just found the story very intense. It was very intermingled. There's a lot of questions to be answered, and he even goes and he's researching through his mentor's books and researching for his own book, and it's just very intense, and it's so good. Like, I can't even get over how good this is. I need to make my best friend read this. I need somebody else to read this. So if you have this on your bookshelf, I need to discuss it with somebody, and I have nobody to discuss it with, so it's killing me inside. I'm like, no, please. Characters, I give a 5 out of 5. I absolutely loved all these characters. They were so good and so different. I especially like the character Nola, because we're kind of figuring out why she was murdered, because people accuse Harry and he had an affair with her, and they're like, did it end wrong, something like that, but you're like, why would he kill her, because he still claims he loves her. So it's very intriguing. There's kind of creepiness because Harry was an adult dating a minor, so there's a little bit of, like, you know, creepiness there. It was kind of weird to read about, obviously, because it's not legal and it's odd, but it was an odd coupling. But it's very intriguing at the same time, because it's very mysterious, because you don't know if this was a crime of passion or it's just a mistake or somebody else was plotting. Like, you don't know what's gonna happen. I really like the character Marcus. I felt like he was very much a very good narrator because he was flawed and he admits his flaws and he gets other people to admit his flaws and he starts out a certain way and like you kind of see him grow throughout the novel and grow by learning about Harry. I really liked Harry, who was the author. His kind of like, you get to learn about 1975, so he was about 30 years old and now it's present day and he's like 60 or approaching 60 or he's 60 or he's past 60, somewhere around that age range. And you kind of see how his life kind of, how it started off like really like hopeful, and you get to see the people in the town like Jenny and her mother, and I'm forgetting a lot of the characters' names because I read this so fast and in such a rush because I wanted to know what was going to happen. But you get to see all the townspeople from 1975 fast forward, and they're like kind of helping piece together the puzzle, and there's a lot of discrepancies in a lot of the police reports, so there's them going through that. It brings in people from other towns and people that certain people don't know about connected to Nola, and you get to find out Nola's past and stuff like that. So it's very interesting. Cover, I give a 5 out of 5. I really like this cover. It actually, the spine really got me to pick it up because it was very interesting. If you see, it's kind of like those like cutout letters. I really like the cover, this blue gradient and on the back. Like, I just find it a very appealing cover to pick up. I don't know. I really love blue covers. It's something about them. And suspense, I give it a 5/5. Obviously, I read it so fast, wanted to know what was going to happen, so I was addicted to it for days. And then overall, I give it a 5/5. I'm definitely going to be rereading this sometime, not soon, but I'd say maybe next summer I might give it a reread, because obviously it's a thriller, so it's harder to reread after. But this book, because it's a book within a book and there's so many different parts and so many different layers, I could definitely see me rereading it even at a few months, like 2 months. Like, it's that good. And yeah, if you haven't read this, definitely recommend. If you've taken a lot of any of my recommendations before and you really like them, wouldn't hesitate with this one because it's so good. But obviously, if you don't like this kind of thing, I wouldn't go with it because you might not like it. But if you like this sort of thing, this like kind of thriller that's not too scary, definitely recommend. And I want to thank you guys so much for watching. If you've read it, definitely let's discuss in the comments. And I'll see you guys later. Bye.